now that we introduced the Perceptron algorithm and talked about the computing environment, let's actually get coding and implement a Perceptron in Python. So for this, we are going to use a JupyterLab environment so that we can execute code incrementally and talk about it. So we will start by installing some of the essential libraries we will be using. So for this code notebook, we will need NumPy, Pandas, and Matplotlib, which I'm just installing right now. So after installing these libraries, there's also a little library I really like using. It's Watermark. It's something I developed a few years ago just to check that we have the expected package versions. So once you have it installed, it's optional, but you can use it to check the version for NumPy, Pandas, and Matplotlib here. This is sometimes useful if you want to run the same code on your computer and want to make sure you get exactly the same results. So now let's get to the more interesting part and load the dataset. We will be using Pandas here to load the dataset, which is formatted as a text file with tab-separated values. So the dataset here consists of two feature columns, X1 and X2, and the label column, which contains the class labels. We will then use the variable x_train to store the feature columns, and we will use the variable y_train to store the class labels. Just to make sure everything looks correct, let's execute this code to see that everything is formatted correctly. And it indeed looks like everything should be formatted correctly. So we have an array here with two feature columns. So now xTrain is a NumPy array, and we can actually use the .shape attribute to check its shape. So in this case, we see the NumPy array has 20 rows and two feature columns, just as we expected. And correspondingly, yTrain.shape will return 20 because we have 20 class labels. Personally, what I like doing is also using the NumPy bin count function, which gives us the number of class labels here. And in this case, we have a binary classification dataset. So the first number refers to the number of zeros in this dataset, and the second number refers to the number of ones in this dataset. So here we have 10 data points from class label 1 and 10 data points from class label 0. So before we get to the actual coding of the Perceptron, let's quickly visualize this dataset. For the visualization here, we are going to use Matplotlib, which is one of my favorite plotting libraries, because it's versatile and very customizable. So the plotting code is a little bit involved. So let's look at the results first, and then we will discuss how we got the actual plot. So as we can see here, we have the two feature columns, X1 and X2, as the axes of our scatter plot. And just like in the previous video, we use the blue diamond to indicate class label 0, and we use the orange triangle to denote class label 1. So how did this code work? So what we did here is we plotted both classes separately. So this code is for class label 0, and this code is for class label 1. So what happened here is we used the label array to select all the data point indices that correspond to class label 0. And here, this line corresponds to the first feature column. So in NumPy, the first index refers to the rows, and the second index refers to the columns. So with this line, we are selecting all the data points belonging to class label 0, and for that, only feature column number 1. The second line here plots the y-axis. So here, we again select all the data points corresponding to class label 0, and we pick out the second feature column. So this whole plot will then eventually plot all the blue diamonds in this plot that you can see here. The second plot function here does the same thing except for class label 1. So here we are selecting all the data points corresponding to class label 1, which will then be visualized here as the orange triangles. So the rest of this code is really just for like adding a little bit of eye candy, where we have a plot legend, we trim the axes here, and then we add the label information to the axes. And that's essentially it. So this is all the code we need to visualize the data set. And now we have also a better idea of how it looks like. And if you remember, this is exactly the same data set that we used in the videos before when we explained the Perceptron algorithm. So now we're actually going to code the Perceptron algorithm to do the classification really from scratch on this code example. So now that we visualized our data set, in the next video, let's get to the really interesting part and code our Perceptron.